Good afternoon and welcome to St. Robert Parish. We have a few announcements. The St. Robert plant sale order forms are due by next Tuesday, April 20th, and will be available for pickup beginning May 14th. If you have any questions, please contact Kathy Wyatt or Mary Lynn. Thank you for your support. Welcome to members of the Kepler family who are joining us today to celebrate Paul and Dorothy's 50th wedding anniversary. Father Enrique, Father Andrew, and the Pastoral Council seek new members. If you are interested in joining this critical council to help lead St. Robert in vision and mission, nominate yourself or someone else today. Meetings take place the first Thursday of the month at 6:30 p.m., starting July 1st. See the newsletter, bulletin, and back of church for ways to nominate. Thank you for your consideration.
Please rise.
This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Worthy is Christ the Lamb who was slain, whose blood set us free to be people of God. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Power, riches, wisdom, and strength, and honor, blessing, and glory are His. This is the for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
Your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers. And for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and still the greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you have created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy. For through water, you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water, the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon the human race. And last of all, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We humbly ask you, Almighty God, to be pleased in your faithful love to bless this salt you have created. For it was you who commanded the prophet Elisha to cast salt into water. that impure water might be purified. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that whenever this mixture of salt and water be sprinkled, every attack of the enemy may be repulsed, and your Holy Spirit may be present to keep us safe at all times, through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen. And let us give glory to our God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Lord, let your face shine upon us, shine upon us, shine upon us. Lord, let your face shine upon us, shine upon us, shine upon us. Listen to my song, hear me when I call, O Lord, my God, be gracious, hear my prayer. Shine upon us, shine upon us, shine upon us. You have called my name, set your seal upon my heart. You hear me when I call. Lord, let your face shine upon us, shine upon us, shine upon us.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Now in our presence the Lord will appear, shine in the faces of all of us here, fill us with joy and cast out all our fear.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do your questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. That it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms might be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord. Archdiocese of Milwaukee, safeguarding all of God's family, Safe Environment Week proclamation. Whereas Safe Environment Week is for every parish and school, as well as the entire faith community, to emphasize at the same time and the importance of keeping our children and youth safe. Whereas child abuse and neglect are societal problems whose prevention depends on involvement among people throughout the faith community. Whereas our children are our most valuable resources and will shape the future of not only the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, but also the entire church. Whereas the theme of this year's Safe Environment Week will be, we are all responsible for creating safe environments. Whereas acknowledging that a church, we have much work to do to rebuild the trust that has been broken. Whereas we acknowledge that as bishops, clergy, and church leaders, we must work together as a community to increase awareness about child abuse and neglect, and work to promote the social and emotional well-being of children, youth, families in a safe, healthy, and nourishing environment. Therefore, I, Archbishop Jerome E. Listecki, proclaim the week of April 18th through April 24th, 2021, as Safe Environment Week in the Archdiocese of Milwaukee. I ask that all participate and acknowledge each other with the love and mercy of God the Father. Most Reverend Jerome E. Listecki, Archbishop of Milwaukee. I'm not the Archbishop, I'm just reading, all right? Don't confuse me with the Bishop. The proclamation that I just read is so important because as human nature, as human beings, as society, and unfortunately as a church, we have suffered greatly because of the crimes against children and against vulnerable adults. And we, as people of God, as a church, as a community, need to learn from past mistakes of how we have turned a blind eye, of how we have allowed men and women to abuse children and the most vulnerable. And we cannot continue to let that happen. So Archbishop Listecki, as the one pastor and responsible for the whole archdiocese, he's asking each one of us to take part in keeping safe anyone, not only children, but every single human being, of any abuse that anybody can suffer, especially within our own Catholic Church. So, Archbishop Listecki cannot do it by himself. We as priests cannot do it by ourselves. Leaders of the church cannot do it by ourselves. We need all of us to create that safe environment. Because children are not only being abused in the Catholic Church. Most abuses actually happen within the hearts of the family. And it's a crime, it's a sin that we need to get rid of. And why is this so important? Because in today's gospel, we hear how the Lord, after his resurrection, came to the apostles and showed that he has flesh and bones. That the same body of Christ who was born from Our Lady, our Mother Mary, the same body that walked throughout the earth, the same body that died on the cross, rose from the dead as a glorifying body. So, and we believe in the resurrection of the body. And our bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit. And therefore, if that is our belief, that this body that you have, the body that the Lord has created for you, will be with you forever. Because like it or not, you're stuck with your body. It's going to be a glorified body in heaven, but it's going to be your body forever. And therefore, we recognize the sacredness of human beings and the sacredness of our bodies. And therefore, we need to protect our bodies and the bodies of the most vulnerable, our children. And we need to teach them how to be safe. And we need to create that environment to keep them safe. And it's all of us who need to have our eyes open in order to keep everybody safe. So this task of that Archbishop Listeki has embarked us this week, this is not a work of only 1 week. It cannot be the work of only 1 week. And I, as the administrator of St. Robert's and Holy Family, will do everything in my power to keep everybody safe. But I need your help to continue to keep everybody safe. Again, not only in our campus, in our parishes, not only in our school, but even in your own families. So let us commit ourselves that the selfishness and the crimes and the sin that has hurt us so much, that has hurt so many people, may end. As Archbishop Listeki mentioned, this is not a problem of the Catholic Church. This is a problem of our whole society. And how horrible this crime is. So let us ask the Lord today to help us see the beauty of our own bodies, to see the sacredness of our own bodies and the sacredness of the body of every human person we meet. That by recognizing their dignity, we may be able to honor and to respect it every single day. And that the power of Christ may continue to heal us, especially that justice may be done in order to continue to move forward and to keep our children safe. So let us pray through the intercession of Mary, our mother, for the safety of all children as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen. All right, but not everything today is dark. We are still at Easter. We are still in celebrating. And today, we have the great honor to welcome a wonderful couple who are celebrating, according to how they look, like 10 years of marriage. They look really young. But no, actually, you are celebrating 50. I don't know how to say 50 anymore. All right. So, how you did it? Huh?
One day at a time.
One day at a time. All right. That's wonderful. That's how life goes, isn't it? One life at a time.
Huh? You gotta marry the right one.
And you had to marry the right one. All right. Good. Excellent. What a nice compliment. Yeah, excellent. But it's not easy, and it's not only the two of you working together, it's the whole family who is supporting you throughout your whole lives. And as you sacrifice your life for them, they do it for you as well. And what a wonderful example you are giving us to be faithful, to love, and to be faithful no matter how many years the Lord give you. And we pray for another 50 going forward. It's piece of cake. The first 50 are the difficult ones. The next 50 are the easiest ones. But let us pray today, praising the Lord for blessing your marriage, and we ask you to continue to bless you in your journey toward heaven together. So let us pray for the two of you. Lord God and Creator, we bless and praise your name. In the beginning you made man and woman so that they may enter a communion of life and love. You likewise bless the union of these your servants, that they might reflect the union of Christ with his church. Lord, with kindness and them today, amid the joys and struggles of their life, you have preserved the union between them. Renew their marriage covenant, increase your love in them, and strengthen their bond of peace, so that surrounded by their children, they may always rejoice in the gift of your blessing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations. Please rise. And let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, through God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, with our hearts open in faith, let us pray for those in need.
That Pope Francis and our ordained leaders will be faithful teachers of the gospel and live by what the church professes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our government will work for peace and provide aid and food for those who need it, especially during the pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those contemplating a call to religious life will hear the word of God and follow his will for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we will bear witness to the suffering and rising of Christ in all we do. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will bless Evangeline Grace Shearburn, who is being baptized at St. Robert this weekend, and Mac Baim and Justine Sorensen, who are married at St. Robert this week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and housebound will be granted healing and peace, especially those affected by COVID. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parents, teachers, catechists, and all who work with children and young people, that they may be faithful in their responsibility to protect those entrusted to them by providing safe environment for our children to live, learn, and grow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those that journey with the survivors of abuse, the counselors, law enforcement, therapists, family members, and advocates, that the Holy Spirit may guide their words and actions in their healing ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died will share in the true presence of God, especially Joseph and Margaret Andreuzzi, the intention of this Mass, and for our personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, hear our prayers and help us to live as faithful witnesses to Christ, risen among us, through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleases our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more. The Lamb was slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. All you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and made them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new an eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Peter, with Saint John the Evangelist, with Saint Francis de Sales, with Saint Robert, and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church and earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Jerome, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And let us pray for this couple who are celebrating 50th years of marriage, that the Lord may continue to bless their union and their family through the intercession of our mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. And now it's a privilege to me to show, to introduce some of my brother knights who are here with the Knights of Columbus. We see their emblem here in front of the church, and they are going to help us understand a little bit about the Knights of Columbus. Please be seated.
Thank you, Father Enrique. My name is Ed Ricker, and I am the Grand Knight for the Council 4706 of the Knights of Columbus. Our members are from the North Shore of St. Eugene's, St. Monica, Holy Family, and St. Robert. Our mission statement is, Council 4706 of the Knights of Columbus is a Catholic men's organization serving under the protection of our Blessed Mother and her Immaculate Conception. Our council is dedicated to the principles of charity, unity, fraternity, and patriotism. We provide services to the church, our members, parishes of the North Shore, and needs of the greater Milwaukee community. With Father's blessing, who is a fellow knight, he has allowed us and would like us to increase our presence and membership here at St. Robert's. One of our tenets is that we pray for and financially assist vocations. This past year, we virtually passed the hat and collected $4,500 for seminarians. That means $1,500 went to each of the three seminarians of the four parishes. That means $1,500 went to your seminary in Juan. It is very important to us to support our parish priests. For example, because of the pandemic, both St. Eugene's and St. Monica had a severe shortage of ushers. Father Paul called on the knights, and we now have knights ushering at all the masses at both parishes. The knights also believe in the power of prayer. We pray the rosary to support our members and non-members in whatever needs there may be. The Knights also believe that life begins at conception. We financially provide and pray for those organizations that support the unborn, such as the Women's Care Center. But most importantly, we believe in our charitable works. We recently held a blood drive and collected more than 50 pints of blood that will help dramatically during these challenging times. During Lent, we held a hygiene bag drive for the Capuchin Community Services that houses the homeless and the poor of Milwaukee and provided them with much needed hygiene products. One of our mottos is to leave no neighbor behind. We recently were asked to help a gentleman who has dementia and was involved in a hoarding situation. We answered the call to help him declutter and clean his apartment. We will soon be holding our Tootsie Roll drive, where we collect money to support organizations that support people that are physically and mentally challenged. So if you're interested in helping your parish priest when needed, and the greater Milwaukee community, where the need is always there, then the Knights of Columbus are for you. I am proud to be a member of the Knights of Columbus. I, along with my brother Knights, will be in the back of church and would love to talk to you. Thank you and God bless.
So the Knights of Columbus.
The Knights of Columbus are here not only to show how wonderful they are as an organization in the Catholic Church, but especially I want the Knights to be active here at St. Robert's and our Holy Family, my other parish. But the Knights of Columbus are very active in their own parish. So Father Paul has them very busy at their own parishes, and that's the goal. So we need our parishioners, our men, here to join the Knights of Columbus and continue to be active in the parish, but as to see how much impact the Knights of Columbus can do over time. The founder was a priest in Philadelphia, I believe, and he was an American priest, and now he's a blessed in the church. Pope Francis named him a blessed, which is one step before we are called him a saint. And he established the Knights of Columbus in a time where families were struggling and communities were struggling. And he established the Knights of Columbus that men, Catholic men, will step up to the plate to really make them holy men in the service of our communities and our parishes. And they have done such a wonderful thing throughout the years to continue to maintain the holiness of our Catholic Church, the holiness of our men in our parishes. So, but we need you. We need you, men, to continue to join the Knights of Columbus, to discern if that's what God is calling you to do, because it's such a wonderful organization. I am a Knights of Columbus, and I have been benefiting from the Knights of Columbus since I came to America, because one of their ministries is to support seminarians. And I received many of their support when I was in seminary, and the latest support that they have to the parish was to support Juan, our own seminarian here at St. Robert. So the Knights of Columbus are here around to answer any questions that you have, and really encourage you to talk to these guys, because they are such a wonderful example of how to serve parishes. And you see now they have vests and everything, but usually they don't like to wear all of that. Usually they are helping in the background. They don't want to be the show, the center of the show. They want in the background serving the parish and the church. And a lot of men used to join them because they used to have swords. You still have swords? Not anymore? So we lost that, but and the sword was the defendants of the faith. So they continue to defend the faith by actively living our Catholic faith. So I really encourage you to join us as being one of the Knights of Columbus. Thank you guys for being here. I appreciate it. Please rise. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And let us pray for the end to this pandemic. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and their snares, the devil. May God rebukingly, humbly pray into the Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl around the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. As always, please leave your kneelers down where you are, and you help us sanitize everything after Mass. We'll greatly appreciate it. And again, to congratulations and your anniversary of marriage.
Gladness and the joyful valleys ring with
the splendor of the nations. He's the